In this exercise, we are going to parametrize the curve of intersection for the surfaces z equals 2x plus 2 and z equals x squared plus y squared minus 1. Let's take a moment and visualize these surfaces because they're pretty recognizable. So z equals 2x plus 2, that's going to be a plane. And then z equals x squared plus y squared minus 1, that's a paraboloid. It's like your classic paraboloid, but that minus 1 means we've just shifted it down one unit so that the z-intercept is negative 1. Okay, this plane slices into this paraboloid and traces out what looks to me like a tilted circle. That's the curve that we want to describe. Now, when we see that we need to parametrize this curve, what we want, the goal, is to write down a parametric description for this curve, which is going to be a vector-valued function of the single parameter t. For a curve, it's just one parameter. What needs to happen is that as we let t go through some domain for that parameter, we need to trace out the x, y, and z coordinates for any point on this curve of intersection. So we need to be able to say what x, y, and z are in terms of t. So that's the goal, so I'm writing kind of high, is to write down this parametric description where x, y, and z are all described in terms of t. For t going from some value a to some value b, here, because this is a tilted circle, you can probably expect that this is going to be 0 and 2 pi. This curve we want to describe is a curve of intersection, which means it both lives on the plane z equals 2x plus 2 and on the paraboloid z equals x squared plus y squared minus 1. So any triple x, y, and z on that curve of intersection must make both equations simultaneously true. Whenever you're looking to describe an intersection in mathematics, what you usually want to do is find some way to bring the information together. It's the case that for any point on this curve of intersection, its z-coordinate is twice its x-coordinate plus 2. But also, for the same point, it must be the case that the z-coordinate is the x-coordinate squared plus the y-coordinate squared plus 1, because it satisfies both equations. What we can do is substitute 2x plus 2 from the plane equation into z for the paraboloid equation to say that 2x plus 2 equals z, which equals x squared plus y squared minus 1. Okay, so since both equations must simultaneously be true, we basically got rid of our z-coordinate, bringing the x and y coordinates together into this equation, which is combining information from the plane and from the paraboloid. We have these quadratic terms in x and y, and then this first order term in x. When you see something like that, what you want to think about is completing the square. So let me bring this constant 1 over here. We'll write 3 equals x squared minus 2x plus y squared. Let's take the x squared minus 2x and do the process of completing the square on this expression in x. Take the negative 2, divide by 2, you get negative 1. So I go ahead and write x minus 1, that quantity squared, plus y squared. Then what I want to do is square this out. I'm going to do it out loud and see how I've changed the right-hand side. I need to enact the same changes on the left-hand side. So were I to square this, I would get x squared, that's here. Minus x is this minus 2x. But then I get also a plus 1. That's new on the right-hand side, so we need to add 1 to the left-hand side. This means that the x and y coordinates on this curve of intersection make this equation true. What is this? So take a moment to figure out what this is and see if you can go ahead and write down a nice parametric description for this, and then I will come back and show you what I would like to do. For the x and y coordinates, this equation defines a circle of radius 2, the square root of 4, centered at 1, 0. So this is a circle of radius 2 centered at 1, 0. If x and y live on the circle of radius 2 centered at 1, 0, then we want to revert to the standard polar parametrization for this circle. Now, typically, circles are centered at the origin almost always when you're working through math problems. Our circle is shifted one unit on the right on the x-axis. So I'm going to say, you know, classically, x is r cosine t, where here r, the radius, is 2. So you would write 2 cosine t, but I need to add 1. So this is the radius times cosine of t, shifted one unit to the right on the x-axis. Y is not shifted though, so y is just going to be 2 sine t. What happens now if I do x minus 1? X minus 1 is just 2 cosine t. Square that, you get 4 cosine squared plus this quantity, which is 4 squared is 4 sine squared. 4 cosine squared plus 4 sine squared is 4. Okay. We have now established that for any point on this curve of intersection, its x and y coordinates satisfy the equation 4 equals x minus 1 squared plus y squared. In other words, they live on a circle of radius 2 centered at 1, 0. So they should be described using this polar description. We need to describe z in terms of t. We have z characterized in terms of x and y two different ways. Both would land us on the curve of intersection. So z equals 2x plus 2, but also z equals x squared plus y squared minus 1. Take a moment to decide which of these two equations you would like to work with, and then see if you can write down a nice expression for z in terms of t. I think the plane equation will give us the most immediate expression for z in terms of t. Z is twice the x-coordinate plus 2. Well, this is the x-coordinate, so let's double it and add 2. I think we're ready now to say what the curve of intersection is for this parametric description. Let me squeeze it up here at the top. For this curve of intersection, the x-coordinates are 1 plus 2 cosine of t, 2 sine of t, and then double the x-coordinate and add 2. So that's 2 plus 4 cosine t plus 2 overall, that's 4 plus 4 cosine of t. We need to traverse the circle once. So using our standard polar description means the parameter should go from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, we finished the exercise. This is the parametric description for the curve of intersection. What I'm going to do is step away now so you can copy down anything left over, and then I will put up a demonstration showing these two surfaces intersecting and this parametric description tracing out the curve as t goes from 0 to 2 pi.